In this video segment, I'm going to talk about something that we've been dancing around, and that's the issue of what we call the classical dichotomy. So a dichotomy is when things are split into two opposing or totally separate categories, you know, good and evil, black and white, so on and so forth. And the classical dichotomy says that all economic variables are either nominal or real. And nominal variables are expressed in currency units. So, for instance, your nominal wage might be $10 an hour. And nominal is a word that basically comes back to the idea of name, like nombre in Spanish. Real variables are not expressed in currency units. Or they're expressed in inflation-adjusted units. So, one way of looking at this is, if your wage is $10 an hour and a gallon of milk costs $4, then what's your wage in terms of gallons of milk? Your wage, we could say, is 2.5 gallons of milk per hour. And notice here that when we take two nominal variables and construct a ratio of them, the dollar signs kind of cancel out, and we get a real variable. So typically, the ratio of two nominal variables is a real variable. And that might sound sort of hopelessly arcane, or sort of why the heck does this matter? Because when we put things in a ratio, we're putting them in a context. If I tell you that your wage is $10 an hour, that actually doesn't tell you that much. $10 an hour right now, you might sort of struggle to support a family, but $10 an hour 20 or 40 years ago would have been a really good wage. So the idea here is that by putting things in this ratio, we compare them to something else and we put them in context. So ratios put things in context. So that's why, say, for instance, also, we look at things like GDP per capita, the ratio between a country's GDP and its total population, because then we have some information about the context. How much does that real GDP actually mean? So, this classical dichotomy is something that we're going to go ahead and look at when we think about what's called money neutrality. So money neutrality is the idea that in the long run, changes in the money supply don't affect real variables. And essentially the idea is something like this. Let's suppose we think about a country's total GDP. And a country's total GDP depends upon, you know, what its natural resources are and how big its labor force is and how talented they are and how much capital they have and how much, what the level of technology is and so on and so forth. If we go ahead and say doubled the money supply, or let's say even multiplied by 10, so we all pull all the currency out of our pockets and just add a zero to it, and all the banks add a zero to all of our bank accounts, but also to all of our debts, then what's going to happen? Well, essentially, we've just scaled everything up by a factor of 10. And probably what would mainly happen is that businesses would scale up their prices by a factor of 10 as well. And it wouldn't really change much in the economy. So that's the basic argument here, that in the long run, production is constrained by the supply of the factors of production. Land, labor, capital, etc. And if we go ahead and print lots of money, we can't summon up, you know, more factories just by printing money. We can't, you know, make land more fertile just by printing more money. We can't instantly give people an education by printing more money. We might be able to sort of engage in some government spending using the money, but that's sort of a different question. That's a question of what happens when you change government spending and use it to make some investments. So the money supply change itself, we think, does not have real long-run effects.